I'm Joan Graham, your guide to sharing the universe. Our series of outreach training videos produced by the Astronomical Society of the Pacific. In this episode, Getting Started with Outreach, we explore deep philosophical questions like, why do outreach in the first place? What are the personal benefits of doing outreach? What are the benefits to my astronomy club? If I do outreach and no one comes, is it still outreach? Well, hold on to your hats, because we're going to give you some great tips on how to get involved. But first, let's ask some amateur astronomers why they enjoy sharing the universe with the public.
The public wants to hear it, and they want to hear it at all ages.
The gasps and the, oh, cool or awesome.
It's a way to learn for myself.
And it helps our club grow and helps our mission.
If you're interested in astronomy, share it.
The things we do for ourselves die with us, but the goodness and we do for others goes on and lasts after us.
These amateur astronomers have concluded that sharing the universe with the public is the coolest thing you can do to contribute to your community, make you a superhero, and boost your ego. Okay, but where do you begin? Getting started with outreach is easy. A great first step is to attend one of your club's public events. See for yourself what goes on. You can just attend. You don't have to present anything. Don't be scared. Go in disguise, like me. Once you see how excited the visitors are, those wow moments when they learn about the night sky, you'll want to get involved as well. But maybe you're asking yourself, what can I do? What can I offer visitors? I can't speak for the universe. Well, you can have a role even if you don't bring a telescope. You can take photos of your club's events, point out constellations, greet visitors and hand out star maps, display an astronomy poster, show your collection of astrophotos or your model of the lunar module. Soon you'll get the bug for outreach too. But if outreach is so much fun, why isn't every amateur astronomer doing it already? Let's see.
I'm too shy to stand up in front of a group. What if people ask me a question I can't answer? My telescope is too small.
I don't know how to talk to kids.
But don't you have three kids of your own?
I hate questions about UFOs and faking the Apollo mission and aliens. Even I get bored when I talk. I don't know where to start. I don't know what to say.
Fear not, amateur astronomers, you're in the right place. Sharing the Universe is a series of videos that addresses these concerns and give you easy to follow tutorials to walk you through many outreach scenarios. Put your worries aside and keep watching. Just remember, no matter your experience level, you can make an important contribution to astronomy outreach. Why not take the first step and attend your club's next public astronomy event? You'll see that it's not so scary. In addition to these videos, you can get a lot more ideas to help you get started sharing the universe at astrosociety.org/sharingtheuniverse. Feel free to send this video to all your friends and colleagues. Thank you for listening. And be sure to check out the full set of Sharing the Universe outreach training videos for more tips on successful public outreach.
It's a calm and cloudless night. Come outside with me tonight and I can show you wonders of the world to surprise and delight. Got my telescope with me. Just wait until you see. We'll stand on the shoulders of giants. That Copernicus was right. Come outside with me tonight, and I can show you wonders of the world to surprise and delight. Got my telescope with me. Just wait until you see. We'll stand on the shoulders of giants.
Stand on the shoulders of giants.